YouTubers, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Here, I thought it was my weather that was slowing down my internet. Well, it wasn't the case. We're having solar flares. There's been 6 M-class solar flares so far today from the area over here, sunspot area 3165. Here you can see spaceweatherlive.com, and we got 6. This one here was a M3, it looks like. There's also a M2. They got down here. Oh, I can't tell. Let's see. Oh, M6. Okay, M6. Where'd it go? M6.36. But there's been 6 of them. And there's been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it looks like. 6, 7, 8. Yeah. C-class flares in the last couple days. Actually, quite a few more. SWPC.NOAA.gov has 6 flare. R2 moderate occurred today, December 14, 2022. An R2 moderate high frequency radio blackout occurred today, December 14th at 9:42 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. This was a result of a M6.3 flare that occurred in region 3165. Additional lower level M-class flares also occurred in region 3165 and 3153 earlier today. That would be on the eastern side of the solar disk. You notice over here, 3153 is rotating around the side of the disk. And it says region 3165 will be on the visible solar disk for another 2 days before beginning to rotate to and beyond the limb. The region increased in complexity overnight and remains capable of producing additional M-class flares and a slight chance of an X-class flare. R3 strong flare, and we'll have to keep an eye on that. So here we have the scale for radio blackouts, and let's come down to R2. High frequency radio, limited blackout for hi-fi radio communications on the sunlit side, loss of radio contact for tens of minutes. This is on every side facing the sun, the earth. That is facing, you know, daylight side. It's not limited to, you know, the South American anomaly or wherever. It is the entire earth or sun facing side of the earth. Once again, this is not limited to any particular part of the Atlantic Ocean or even the Pacific Ocean. I just refreshed this and it looks like we got a C3.8 that just came in also. They're currently saying there is a 1% chance for an X-class solar flare, 20% for more M-class, and 85% for C-class flares. Here on Twitter, for space weather, they have the radio blackouts, high-frequency radio blackouts. Now, this was as of about an hour ago. This was 1710 Universal Time. Let me bring this down. Here, I thought it had to do with the storm. We've had 2 days of freezing rain. The power's been flickering maybe twice here where I'm at. And I thought that was the reason. But we're supposed to also get snow. But this is probably what happened. They also have an image with a circle of the area that produced the M6.3 solar flare. Here on soho.nasa.com, we'll play the image, and hopefully it'll be fairly recent so we can see. There's one, yeah, coming off that eastern limb. You can see the date down there at the bottom. Yeah, it goes all the way up until about 1400 hours. And I'll stop it with what I'll do. And we'll move it ahead one little section at a time. Yeah, good thing it wasn't earth-facing. Otherwise, we'd be in a whole heap of more blackouts for from radio frequency. You have 1436. That's the most. Let's see, 1538. Yeah, that's the most recent image that they have. Here's another more recent image of the sun. Now, these are stills. Yeah, you can see these areas here are really quite active. I don't think, yeah, they got the time. But again, this is not up to date. You can see it's 1306 universal. And as you know, our jet stream is broke. And as you know, the Earth's magnetic field is weakening, which allows more solar radiation to impact us. And this will cause adverse weather and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. And then maybe you'll feel a little more safe. And God bless you. Bye.